हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल बी स्पीकिंग अबाउट वाटर पोटेंशियल एंड केमिकल पोटेंशियल एंड दिस इज़ अ पार्ट ऑफ प्लांट फिजियोलॉजी एंड मेटाबॉलिज्म। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शुड नो दैट व्हाट इज़ वाटर पोटेंशियल। वाटर पोटेंशियल इज़ ऑल्सो डिनोटेड बाय साई एंड इट इज़ द केमिकल पोटेंशियल ऑफ वाटर इन अ सिस्टम और पार्ट ऑफ अ सिस्टम विच इज़ एक्सप्रेस्ड इन यूनिट ऑफ प्रेशर। केमिकल पोटेंशियल इज़ द फ्री एनर्जी पर मोल ऑफ एनी सब्सटेंस दैट इज़ पर ग्राम मॉलिक्यूलर वेट। जब भी हम केमिकल पोटेंशियल की बात करते हैं तो एक ग्राम मॉलिक्यूलर वेट के अंदर जितनी फ्री एनर्जी प्रेजेंट होती है दैट इज़ एक्चुअली द केमिकल पोटेंशियल ऑफ दैट वाटर। इन अदर वर्ड्स यू कैन ऑल्सो से दैट द केमिकल पोटेंशियल इज़ द नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ अ सब्सटेंस अंडर कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर एंड प्रेशर। एक फिक्स टेम्परेचर पर और फिक्स प्रेशर पर किसी भी मोल के अंदर जितने नंबर ऑफ किसी भी केमिकल के अंदर सॉरी जितने नंबर ऑफ मोल प्रेजेंट होते हैं दैट इज़ एक्चुअली द केमिकल पोटेंशियल ऑफ दैट सॉल्यूशन। इन केस ऑफ वाटर वी कैन से दैट पर मोल जितने नंबर ऑफ वाटर मॉलिक्यूल प्रेजेंट हैं दैट इज़ द वाटर पोटेंशियल। सो वाटर पोटेंशियल मे बी डिफाइन एज द डिफरेंस इन फ्री एनर्जी पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम बिटवीन प्योर वाटर एंड ऑस्मोटिकली कॉन्स्ट्रेंट मटेरिकली बाउंड और प्रेशराइज्ड वाटर। सो वाटर के केस में पोटेंशियल क्या होगा दैट इज़ द डिफरेंस बिटवीन फ्री एनर्जी पर वॉल्यूम पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम माइनस ऑस्मोटिकली कंप्रेस्ड वाटर। सो वाटर पोटेंशियल ऑफ एनी सिस्टम इज इक्विवेलेंट टू द केमिकल पोटेंशियल ऑफ वाटर इन दैट सिस्टम। किसी भी सिस्टम में वाटर पोटेंशियल जो होता है वो उसके केमिकल पोटेंशियल के इक्वल होता है। सो वाटर पोटेंशियल ऑफ प्योर फ्री वाटर इज़ आर्बिट्रेरी सेट एज ज़ीरो, हमेशा ज़ीरो रहेगा प्योर वाटर का। व्हेन अ सॉल्यूट इज़ एडेड टू प्योर फ्री वाटर द वाटर पोटेंशियल बिकम नेगेटिव बिकॉज द फ्री एनर्जी इज डिक्रीजेस। सो व्हेन प्योर फ्री वाटर इज़ कंप्रेस्ड और हीटेड द पोटेंशियल बिकम पॉजिटिव बिकॉज द फ्री एनर्जी इंक्रीजेस। तो ये आपको हमेशा याद रखना है कि वेन एवर वी आर एडिंग एनी सोल्यूट इन द सोल्यूशन और इन द वाटर इट्स पोटेंशियल बिकम नेगेटिव बिकॉज मॉलिक्यूल के बीच में मूवमेंट के लिए जो फ्री एनर्जी होता है दैट इज़ रिड्यूस्ड। बट वेन एवर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट टेम्परेचर हीट दैट टाइम द स्पेस बिटवीन द मॉलिक्यूल इंक्रीजेज सो द पोटेंशियल बिकम पॉजिटिव। Water potential, as I already told you, is denoted by psi and it can be determined by expressing the difference between the chemical potential of water under the mentioned condition and that of pure water under the standard condition. So the formula is what? Psi equals to mu w minus mu w zero. और इसको आप इस तरीके से भी बोल सकते हैं RT, which is a constant in E epsilon upon epsilon zero. Here R is a gas constant, its value is 8.31 joule kilo per mole. T is the absolute temperature which is denoted by K. E epsilon is the vapor pressure of the solution in the system at a particular temperature T, and epsilon naught is the water pressure of pure water at the same temperature. So its expression is RT in epsilon upon epsilon zero is always zero in a solution. E upon epsilon zero is less than zero, negative ban jata hai jab bhi hum solution ki baat karte hain. Now the water potential of a biological system is usually expressed as negative quantity. Kyunki kisi bhi biological system ke andar hum baat karte hain कि वॉट एवर द लिक्विड इज़ प्रेजेंट इन साइड द सेल दैट इज़ नॉट अ प्योर वाटर दैट इज़ ऑलवेज अ मिक्सचर ऑफ कॉम्पोनेंट्स. सो यू कैन से द पोटेंशियल ऑफ दैट मिक्सचर और दैट बायोलॉजिकल सिस्टम ऑलवेज बी नेगेटिव. सो वेन एवर सॉल्यूट इज एडेड टू प्योर वाटर इट्स वैल्यू पी वैल्यू बिकम नेगेटिव एंड अ डिफ्यूजन प्रेशर डेफिसिट ऑफ वाटर डेवलप्स. नाउ डिफ्यूजन अकॉर्डिंग टू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ मॉलिक्यूलर मोशन और द काइनेटिक थ्योरी the elementary particles are in constant motion at temperature above the absolute zero. Diffusion always involves the net movement of substance from higher concentration to the lower concentration area because of the random kinetic activities of molecules, ions or atoms. तो डिफ्यूजन में कॉन्सेंट्रेशन मॉलिक्यूल का जो मूवमेंट होता है दैट इज़ ऑलवेज हायर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन टू लोअर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन अंटिल जब तक कि दोनों जगह कॉन्सेंट्रेशन सिमिलर ना हो जाए. नेट मूवमेंट ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल रिजल्ट ड्यू टू द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ अ प्रेशर विच मे बी डिफाइंड एज डिफ्यूजन प्रेशर. द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द प्रेशर इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द एवरेज डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द मॉलिक्यूल और डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ डिफ्यूजिबल पार्टिकल्स. दैट मीन्स हायर द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ द पार्टिकल द ग्रेटर देयर डिफ्यूजन प्रेशर. इट इज़ ऑल्सो डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द एब्सोल्यूट टेम्परेचर दैट इज एवरेज एनर्जी ऑफ अ पार्टिकल इज अ होमोजेनस सब्सटेंस राइज एज अ टेम्परेचर इंक्रीज बट इन अ कॉन्स्टेंट फॉर वेरियस सब्सटेंसेज एट अ गिवन टेम्परेचर. The particle velocities in gas can be easily calculated, but it is much more difficult to obtain values for liquid and solids. Pure solvent shows maximum diffusion pressure, that is zero. Whenever solute is added, the chemical potential of the solvent decreases, become negative, and a diffusion pressure deficit results. So, DPD of a solution is the proportional to the amount of the solute added to it. Diffusion is of immense significance in plant water relation with evaporation, a diffusional process being the overall driving force for most water movement through the plant. So in all living cells exist in an aqueous environment and are separated by a differentially permeable membrane which allows only certain substances or you can say the selected molecules to pass but not all. The movement of substance in and out of the cell through the membrane is a matter of diffusion. The phenomenon of diffusion is directly or indirectly involved in all physiological process. All the aerial intake of different gases that is CO2, O2 from the atmosphere as well as the movement of gases through intercellular spaces of tissue takes place by this process. Absorption of water and minerals from the soil by higher plants also takes place by the diffusion phenomena. Although a more complicated mechanism is involved in their absorption and accumulation by the root hairs. The loss of molecules from the plant body is also a diffusional process. Thus, transpiration and loss of CO2 and O2 take place by diffusion. Now, osmosis. Osmosis is a special type of diffusion in which solution and semi-permeable membrane are involved. This is the major difference between osmosis and diffusion, that here there is a semi-permeable membrane which is present and which allows the molecule to pass on it. But in diffusion, there is no as such membrane. When a solution is kept separated from water by a membrane permeable only to water, there tend to be a net flux of water into the solution. As psi is higher in the pure water than in solution, this process is called osmosis. So, in osmosis, solvent molecules spontaneously move from one region where its activity is high to another region where its activity is lower. The membrane that is used in theory is perfectly semi-permeable, which means that it is freely permeable to solvent but impermeable to all solutes. But such a completely semi-permeable membrane is very rare. The membrane employed in practice to demonstrate osmosis between aqueous solution are only selectively impermeable. They generally allow free passage of water and of solutes of small molecular weight, but are completely impermeable to the macromolecules. The semi-permeable membrane is permeable only for the small molecules, small which are small in size, or some specific molecules, but it is impermeable to the macromolecules. As you can see in this diagram, this shows the phenomena of osmosis and demonstrated by a simpler apparatus which is shown in this figure. In this setup, the semi-permeable may be parchment paper. Here you can see this is a flask of a height in which HMM of solution height, H height tak solution fill hai. A membrane is there in the bottom. Solution A is inside the flask and solution B is outside the flask. Pure water or very dilute aqueous solution is placed in the beaker B, and more concentrated aqueous solution whose solute cannot pass through the dividing membrane or semi-permeable membrane, you can say, is placed in beaker A. The volume of liquid in beaker A and B are adjusted so that their levels are identical. Over a period of time at room temperature, the level of A liquid increases. This mechanism, in which A remains stationary at level which is significantly higher than the level in B. At this terminal equilibrium, the solution in A exert a pressure on the semi-permeable membrane which is greater than the counter pressure exerted by the less concentrated solution in B. The magnitude of this pressure difference is measured as the height of the column of a liquid in A at equilibrium. The osmotic pressure pi of a solution is defined as the positive pressure exerted on the solution necessary to prevent a net flux or water between the solution and its pure solvent. So when these are separated by a perfect semi-permeable membrane, at the pore apparatus of the membrane, diffusion of water molecules into the solution will occur, and due to the difference in chemical potential, which creates a localized decrease in pressure resulting in a mass flow of water along the pore. The term osmotic pressure is misleading sometimes. It is in fact an irrational statement. No isolated solution can possess an osmotic pressure, since the phenomena is only demonstrable in a system in which pure solvent and solutions are separated by a semi-permeable membrane. An unconfined solution has an osmotic pressure, although no pressure in the literal sense is exerted, since the osmotic pressure is the pressure that must be imposed upon the solution to maintain its solvent in equilibrium with pure solvent at the same temperature. It is confusing to refer to this pressure as if it were exhibited by the solution. There appears to be need for a new and agreed term to denote solute potential, psi s, or osmotic potential of a solution which is being equal in magnitude but opposite in sign to pi. So pi equals to minus psi s. The development of implant cells is of primary importance in determining their water relationships. Now, law of osmosis. Pi is one of the colligative properties of a solution and shows that osmosis always consists of a net movement of solvent from the dilute to more concentrated solution. When temperature T is constant, the osmotic pressure of a dilute solution is directly proportional to the solute concentration. And here C is expressed as mole per unit volume. Therefore, pi is directly proportional to C when T is constant, or directly proportional to 1 upon V, or pi V equals to constant, which is the analogous of Boyle's law. This is also known as Boyle's law. When solute concentration is constant, the osmotic pressure is directly proportional to the absolute temperature. Pi is directly proportional to T, where C is constant, and this is analogs of Charles' law. When we are combining both of the law, बॉयल्स लॉ एंड चार्ल्स लॉ वी गेट वेंट हॉफ रिलेशनशिप इन विच पाई इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू सी टी एंड पाई इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू सी आर टी वेयर आर इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट विच इज इक्वल्स टू 8.3 किलो जूल पर मोल. थैंक यू. आई होप आप लोगों को वाटर पोटेंशियल मैं बहुत अच्छे से एक्सप्लेन कर पाई हूँ और आपको ये समझ में आ गया है.